Well, this is going to be special. Welcome to the Virtual Honky Tonk. This is going to be the Long Cold Road Edition. From this to whatever this is. Yeah, I figured I'm going to do a long rambling thing. I don't know how long this is going to last, but it's Victoria Day weekend, and it's on a Monday, and I've got the day off, so let's explore. I've got a whole bunch of notes, as Leland Sklar would say, copious notes, and we're going to, well, hopefully have some fun. Oh, but I got some stuff that has never seen the light of day. Probably make somebody upset over YouTube, because there will be cover versions. But I'm going to feature bands I've been in, the best, my favorite songs that they play, and here and there, some of my favorite songs that I did in that band. A little complicated, but so before we get started with the first song, I just wanted to say hello everybody over at Extendicare. Mom, I hope you're well. Don't worry about this little issue. It was a couple of sneezes in a row and I heard something in my eye, but I'm okay. So here's today, middle of May, well, toward the end of May now, and so this was Christmas Day, December 1966, and I had been wanting, oh, note the G.I. Joe on the ping pong table there. Everybody had a ping pong table in their rec room. That was ours. I got a guitar. Not a very good guitar. So I switched to drums soon after. And when I was about 14, 15, I joined a band called Steamin', and there I am, stuffed in the electrical room cabinet. There's my buddy Mike Elder, top right, Jack Outram, bottom right, Shenley Stoughton in the center at the back there, and Wally Ulrichs at the bottom there. That was Steamin'. And we were the hottest thing in Haliburton Highland Secondary School in the gym on May, whatever it was, 1976. And then, I have no recorded history of that. However, what I do have a recorded history of is when I joined this band. Here we are. This was a little bit later in our iteration, but here is the photo taken just before I joined the band. So there it is, Rainbow Wind. And I want to play you one of the songs that we would do when this was us. Two drummers.
What's everybody doing out there?
Okay. And we've got Rudy Campbell, Lori McKinnon, Terry Bethune, and Robert McKinnon.
Thank you.
was the lead singer, Terry Bethune, right here. Whoop, right there. That's Terry. The one the ladies always noticed first. Well, until Rudy joined the band, who we're going to feature right now, Rudy Campbell. And then when it was a four-piece when I joined, it was Jeremy Thomas on drums, Laurie McKinnon on guitar, Terry Bethune on rhythm guitar and vocals, and they sort of had a rotating bass situation. And I offered to, I was a guitar player, I had learned guitar by this point, and offered to, well, you take me on the road, I'll learn the bass and I'll be the best bass player you ever had, come on, come on. And they believed me, so I did. So anyway, that was how I got that job. And so after, let's see that, that was, let's have Rudy. We're going to feature Rudy. Now listen to this. This is so good. Rudy Campbell.
What I'd like to do for you now is a tune by Southside County and Raspberry Juice. Something called The Time, a bit of R&B for you all.
Okay, now that was recorded at the famed Empire Hotel in Huntsville. That was the spring of 1981, so that was the last week of that particular band. Now, going back a ways, this was from the four-person version of Rainbow Wind, and this was with myself, Laurie McKinnon, Terry, and Bob McKinnon. Just the, four-piece. Was recorded in Blind River, 1979. So that was around 79 to 81 is when I was in with Rainbow Wind. Then I got hired by, well, Rainbow Wind came to an end, and Rudy, here's the geographical situation. Rudy and Terry decided to go off and start their own band, and so we just sort of, well, that's that. So I got hired into a country band, the Cliff Carroll and the Hitchhikers. Cliff Carroll and his show. And I was a hitchhiker in his tour bus. Well, the upside was I was making twice the money and the traveling in a bus. Holy cow, a bus. 1958 Bluebird bus that he had converted himself and it caught on fire because he put straight plywood on the exhaust manifold back there when he was setting it all up, and it kind of caught fire when we were trying to cross the ice and the Yellowknife. Anyway, but that was a good thing. The downside was, it was playing the same songs the same way every night. However, turning that into a positive, discipline. This is the band that taught me discipline. You really had to... Arrangements. I worked with Rusty Walker, steel player. And he was old school. You talk like this, you know. Well, we had Tootsie Tillman, the Tennessee Tassel Twirler, in the back, and she was practicing her high kicks and caught her earring in her pantyhose and gave herself a whiplash. You know, and he'd come up with like stuff like that the whole time. And, you know, meanwhile, he's smoking on stage. Everybody had, this is why I'm wearing the vest, is because on all this period of time, we were wearing vests if you wanted to dress up. You could be traveling 400 miles, roll out of the bus, set up, throw on a vest, and play. And that was your, you could get away with that as your, on-air good. I mean, not ideal, ever. But okay, so that winds up up to Cliff Carroll. Then I was, how did this happen? I forget what the connection with Cliff Edwards was. Somehow I got called to go and play a fair board convention, and it was for Cliff Edwards of the Bells. How he got my name, I cannot remember. And but anyway, he used to be with the Bells. And I remember as a kid seeing him on TV. He was on the Mike Douglas Show. So I remember sitting at home watching Cliff Edwards on TV. He's like, man, I remember that guy. And but anyway, I joined the band. And Bob McKinnon was also looking for work. So it was me and Bob joined the Cliff Edwards band with a guy named Charlie Clark and Cliff Edwards. So here, let's have a listen.
Thank you. what's forever for. Thank you very much.
Now that was from a radio broadcast from out east. Out west. That was Saskatchewan. Barkay, Saskatchewan. That was recorded from a live radio broadcast from the Barkay in Saskatchewan. Saskatoon. And one of the neat things about working with Cliff Edwards is that he allowed you the freedom to do the odd tune or two. And in the band, we had Burt Carroll on steel guitar, as I said, Robert McKinnon on drums. I was on bass, and I would do a few tunes to open up the show, and Charlie Clark on guitar. So let's feature Burke from one of the tunes that he would do. Here it is.
We'd like to feature Burke in a tune that is kind of fun, written by Rodney Crowell, who is a hot writer at the moment, and also recorded by Mr. Waylon Jennings. Something entitled, "They Live Along Like This." Oh,
Now that was recorded at the Hotel Brampton in Brampton, and I believe that was May of 1983. And what was noticeable for me around that period of time, because in February of 1983, I had just been to see Stan Rogers at the Bathurst Street Theater, and I took a whole bunch of photos. And this was, like I said, February 1983. And, yeah, see this one right here. I've seen this one show up on somebody's documentary about him. Anyway, it was in June of 83 when he died in that fire, in that airplane disaster. More than we will ever know. But yeah, and so we had just, with Cliff Edwards' band, we were in someplace around Toronto, nearby Toronto, and I hadn't heard the news, and it was Cliff Edwards. He told, you heard who was on that flight? I said, no, didn't hear anything. Because I was on the subway coming to the gig. And it was Cliff who broke the news that it was Stan Rogers. And boy, that was a tough night. That was a tough night. Anyway, and it was a long time before I could listen to Stan Rogers' music again, but I'm back. Anyway, so Cliff, here's one of the songs that I would do in Cliff's band. So here's my contribution.
Baby, step back. Baby, step back. Baby, step up or step back.
So there, you see, there was, he gave you the freedom, you know? Then that band sort of came to an end, and as I was, got a call from Ron Dann, who is one of the unsung heroes of that particular music time, 80s, 70s, 80s. Steel player like no other. Check the Toronto recording records of 70s all through late 80s. Ron Dann is somewhere. If you need a steel, you call Ron. If Ron can't do it, Ron can't do it. but soon there was Burke Carroll. Then Burke was shortly behind. There was also Mike. Oh boy, don't let's move on. Very few of that level. Okay, so next up was J.K. Gully. I got a call from Ron saying, "I have a plan. You play your bass and I'll give you money." And it was for J.K. Gully. It was first I got to go up to meet a guy in a parking lot of a donut shop. That'll be the drummer. Okay, so you go meet the drummer at the parking lot, and which happened to be Adam Ginsberg. Anyway, sure, what the heck? Ha! Hop my bass and my amp on the subway and end up somewhere in the north of Toronto, and there he is. And so anyway, we hop in the car, and he had a car, and we head over to the rehearsal spot. And I was there an hour maybe, and then Ronnie Prophet shows up because it was there because J.K. Gully was looking for guys to be in a tour with Ronnie Prophet, and we were going to be doing. There's Ronnie in the purple pants back there. He's. I remember this day. We all rented gear. Look at those guitars. Oof, Vantage. I mean, nothing wrong with Vantage, but. This, as you can see, that's like a big stadium. And Ronnie was not having it. Something was not going his way. And Ronnie didn't get mad that often, but you can see that JK's dancing as fast as he can. But pretty soon, everything was fine. And Ronnie would get back to Ronnie. And that's how I remember him. He's always happy guy. And talented, holy cow. But I'm getting ahead of this myself just a little bit on the story. I want to do a J.K. Gully song. And very gifted guitar player. Let's play one of his. Sorry, the recording's not very good. Thank you. Okay. That was recorded in Calgary at Longhorn, so 1984. So, boy, that would have been spring of 84, I believe. Because we started in the wintertime, and we were generally out there in the nasty weather. Now, the band was J.K. Gully on guitar, Cyril Rawson on guitar, who's the other guy here with the other vantage, eh? The disadvantage. And Cyril and I went on to write a couple of tunes and did a lot of work together in the studio. And Adam Ginsberg on the drums, and you can see Adam here sitting on the set of Ronnie Prophet's TV show. I don't know what it was called. Something about the Great Western Lodge or something. Anyway, it's not focusing, but sorry. Let's move on. Then we, with the J.K. Gully band, it was designed to be a backup band that we could sort of slide in and sort of pick up entertainers, you know, because J.K. could front a show. I had done years fronting shows with Cliff Carroll, and then I did a year with Cliff Edwards fronting the show, and then bringing him out. And so J.K. would be the star who brought the stars out, the big guys. And so that was an example of him. Then we got a tour with the fabulous Marie Bottrell. And I'd like to play one of those. And just listen to this voice. Hold on, final song. Here it is. Marie Bottrell.
Pull the stones and the walls.
of the tape. That's unfortunate. But that was the last song of the second show at Ranchman's Longhorns in 1984. And along that time, we did a bunch of tours with Ronnie. So here's Ronnie Prophet, the great Mr. Entertainment. Oh boy, there he is. There, that's a photo that I shot of him introducing me. And now here's, I always had a little point and shoot camera in the back of my amp toward the end of my career anyway, because early on I had my big hole camera thing. It just wasn't as convenient. I lost a lot of photos of events like this because I didn't have something small and handy and light, but I got that quickly, and it's kind of blurry. But anyway, that was 53,000 people at Fort Erie at the Friendship Festival around 1990. But again, getting ahead of myself. We had a lot of fun. That's Ronnie, and this is Soundcheck. Like I say, he's in shorts, and I remember I was wearing a t-shirt and a sweater, like a pink shirt and a brown sweater, because I just rolled off the bus, and we were just, you know. Here's Ronnie.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome to the stage the one and the only Mr. Ronnie Prophet.
This is a band that I put together.
I'm an airplane, looking for a place to land. How we doing, gang? Your roadway, probably stretching out your hand. So if you don't mind, I think that I'll stay as long as you let me. For your love is a mystery to the likes of me. Gave me sanctuary, well, they gave me sanctuary. I'm a lost ship, adrift in the night. Oh, but you're a lighthouse, probably stretching out your line. So if you don't mind, I think that I'll stay as long as you let me. Hello, Charlie. Oh, your love is a mystery to the likes of me. Well, they gave me sanctuary. Well, they gave me sanctuary. Here we go. Here in my arms, I know I have found a shelter from the storm. When I turn to you, I know that I found someone soft and warm. Yep, you don't mind, I think that I'll stay as long as you let me. All your love is a mystery to the likes of me. Well, you gave me sanctuary. Will you give me sanctuary? One more time, will you give me sanctuary? Welcome to the Love Boat.
Yo! All right! Good evening! Welcome to the Red Onion. Well, we got a crowd of people tonight. Nice to see you all. Welcome to the Jehovah Witness meeting. I'm Tucker P. Fudbucker.
And the show is on. That was Ronnie Prophet, and that was recorded '86 in around June of '86. Around the same time as I was doing records and stuff, going down to Nashville with that band, included Cyril Rawson from the previous band, Frank Rose, keyboard player, Adam Ginsberg, the drummer from the previous band, who went on to Degrassi Junior High, if you're a fan of that show, come on. He was Mr. Wallfish, if it'll show. But anyway, Adam David. There. That was his acting handle. Adam David. Mr. Wallfish. And these are some Nashville shots with Cyril sort of yucking it up. Let's see, the guy in the white shirt, that's Tony Migliori. Well-respected producer, friend of... He was a Chet Atkins musical director. Here we are. Look at all that tech. Wow. Those were the days. So anyway, it was down here where... Uh-oh. Peanut has joined the party. Hey, buddy, what's going on? I'm telling a story. You here to help? Hey, just let me get you to... Don't step on any of that stuff. Here. Okay. Must be supper time. That was Peanut, by the way. So, yeah. Oh, and we would take breaks and stuff. This is, I believe, we're working on the tune that I was recording. Here, I was working on... He would play a song from the television hit. You know, it's a television TV show. And try and stump me, and he did not. And there, that's... That is the same... I've told this story before. That is the same recording studio where we got iced in, and we were there for two or three days. It was crazy. It was fun, but it was crazy. So that brings us to the song that I got featured to do. I had the week at the Red Onion in Peterborough, and on the weekend I brought in Ronnie Prophet, and he even brought in Gloria Ann Carrier, his wife, and what a time we had. So, I just want to make sure I have it. Where's he? Okay, well, I'm going to move on because I can't find the song I wanted to play. Oh, we're up to Ray Sawyer. Okay, and then, I'm going to save Kalita till the end because some of my absolute favorite songs are coming up at the end. So let's see. Oh, there it is. Sorry. This is a song that I did with Ronnie Prophet around 1986. Here it is.
Well, we're going to do one more tune and bring up the great Mr. Ronnie Prophet. Here's a song by Jackson Browne that we had a request or two for. This is called Rosie.
She was standing at the loading when the trucks rolled up. She was sniffing all around like a half-grown female pup. She wasn't hard to talk to, looked like she had nowhere to go. So I gave her a pass so she could get in and see the show. Well, I sat her down right next to me and I got her beer. While I mixed that sound on the stage so the band could hear. The more I watched her, watch them play, the less I thought of to say. And when they walked off stage, the drummer swept that girl away. Rosie, you're all right. You wear my ring when you hold me tight. Rosie, that's my thing. When you turn on the lights, I got to hand it to me. Looks like it's been you again tonight, Rosie. Oh, kiss and I'd have known from the start she'd come for a star. I might have told my imagination not to run too far. 'Cause all the times that I've been burned, by now you think I'd learn that it's who you look like, not who you are.
Here, keep that in mind.
Rosie, you're all right. Wear my ring when you hold me tight. Rosie, that's my thing. When you turn out the lights, I got to hand it to me. Looks like it's me and you getting a name, Rosie. Looks like it's me and you getting a name. Looks like it's me and you getting a name, Rosie.
Okay, well, that was me with opening for Ronnie Prophet, with Cyril Rawson on guitar, Frank Rose on keyboards, Adam Ginsberg on the drums. And then we hooked up with a different band. I did. I was asked to go, and hey, I believe the conversation went something like this. Says, hey, do you know that Dr. Hook guy, Ray Sawyer, eh? And I go, yeah, I know of him. You want to go on a tour with them? Yeah. And so that's how I recall that conversation. So I want to play a Ray Sawyer tune. Yeah, boy. I think I... Ray Sawyer, here we go. Let's, I'm going to play, I think... yeah, it's hard. He did a lot of really good stuff. And what I like about the song I'm going to play right now is it's not what you would expect him to play. And in this band is Dave Hamilton on a lead guitar, Neil Bentley on bass. I played acoustic rhythm in this one. Yes, acoustic rhythm. Bob Kitt on keyboards, Dan Bone on saxophone, and Gail Runge on the drums. And that was the usual band, but Ray Sawyer brought his own drummer, Jimmy Gunn. So what we're going to hear now is that band with Jimmy Gunn on the drums. Ray Sawyer and Dr. Hook.
All right, here's a song that a good friend of mine from Nashville wrote for me. His name was Bruce Chanel. And I want to thank you for inviting us. Thank you. It's awful nice of you.
Considering we...
Time out.
Oh, he's having a B-52. Time out. Bringing up a tray of B-52s. Hang there. That's it. That is Neil Bentley for guzzling it down. So that band was Neil Hamilton on guitar. I was actually playing electric rhythm on that. Neil Bentley on bass. Bob Kidd on keyboards. Dan Bone on saxophone. And... Jimmy Gunn on the drums, and that was Ray Sawyer of Dr. Hook, and that was the spring of 86 that we toured for about 2 months with Kalita Haverland, who is right here. And I wanted to end with the pink lady of rock, of country anyway, there for a while. There we go. See, look at that. That was the tour. She would come out. Well, I would come out and do 40 minutes. Then we would. Yeah, I would do the first set. Kalita would do the second set. And then Ray Sawyer would come out, finish the show, and do not much Dr. Hook stuff, but, you know, his version of Dr. Hook stuff. But he had this whole bunch of rhythm and blues stuff, which was really good, which I enjoy. But I think we could have done better if we... I think we would have... had we just done the Dr. Hook stuff? You know? Call me crazy, but anyway, here's... I guess that was somewhere along though. This is early in our get-together. And see if... This is how I remember that tour. It was kind of... Well... I don't know if I can even zoom it in there, but... Trying... It was fun. It was a lot of fun. It was crazy, though. And Ray was not into rehearsing. So we kind of... Oh, you guys know it. Give me E, boys. And then we'd be playing something we'd never played. So it was one of those things where it was... Hang on tight, because you never know. And but anyways, like I said, it was some fun. And, okay. Need my folder back. There we go. Now I want to play my two favorite all time. I think the top five, easily in my top five. Anyway, of my experiences while playing on the road, just the sheer joy of playing. I'm going to play you two examples right now back to back. And it just happens to be in Kalita's band. So I don't know what that tells you, but listen to this.
Geez, we have time for about one more, don't we?
I start playing the wrong song.
We got a train coming through the Fort St. John now. No joke. These guys, they slay me. Come on, girls, how you feeling down there? All right. This is for my friends, the girls. It's sweet. We'll be right back.
Okay, so that band was Ken McCall on guitar, the late great Ken McCall, Mike Dasty on the drums, I was on bass, and Dave Murphy on keyboards, and that was Kalita Haverland. And I have one more that I want to play before I wrap things up. This has been a long one. I appreciate you sticking with me, but we're coming to an end. The most logical, this song right here. I don't remember who suggested it. I have no idea. I kind of vaguely remember seeing it on maybe somebody doing it on TV and thinking maybe that's a good idea for us, but I can't swear to it. I just know that it became my favorite point in the whole show is playing this song.
Dance floor's kind of empty. You guys tired as well as hungover? We're going to do an old rock and roll song. Maybe this will get you up to dance and shake your stuff. You know what that is, don't you? Kalita Haverland with Ken McCall on guitar, Mike Dasty on drums, I was on bass and bass vocal, and singing the high parts. That was, and Dave Murphy on keyboards. That was fun. That's one of the things I loved about that. And singing the high part too. It was good work, good workout. But the second solo, the second guitar solo in My Baby Thinks He's a Train and that song are the two pinnacles I think of when I think of my just playing live and the most fun that I've had. So I'm going to end with this. I appreciate all the time you spent here. It's been an adventure for me, sort of reliving these things, trying to recall certain things and not getting off on too many tangents.
I'll finish with this one.
Now I would like to do an original tune that you've probably, maybe, heard maybe. On CJXX. This is a song that I wrote. This is called Where's That Woman?
CJXX. Yes, we do indeed. As I appreciate you spending your time with me, thank you for stopping by. Boy, this has been quite an adventure. Like I say, watch your back, wash your hands, and hopefully we'll see you in the for real land soon. And until then, bye for now.